Hello all, I am Nikhil from iGeeks blog and I am just recording this video after watching the Apple event One More Thing. So let's discuss One More Thing. But before getting started, I would like to request you to subscribe to this YouTube channel and press the bell icon to never miss any update from the iGeeks blog. Now if you have done that, let's move ahead. Apple announced the first Apple Silicon processor for the Mac named M1 chip and it will power the new generation of ARM-based Mac. It is 5 nanometer processor that houses 16 billion transistors just like the A14 Bionic but has been designed specially for a Mac, making them outrageously fast and powerful. We all know that Apple is known for making a bold move. You may have seen this when they introduced the Face ID or removed the headphone jack or when they have reduced the box content. And introducing their own processor means that Apple is transitioning away from the Intel's processor, which can again be considered a bold move in my opinion. The new chip will power Apple's new MacBook Air, Mac Mini, and MacBook Pro 13-inch and other Mac models in the near future. Apple says the new processor will focus on combining power efficiency with performance. Talking about the detailed specification, it has an 8-core of CPU, which the company claims to offer the world's best performance per watt of a CPU. They also said this has 4 fast CPU cores paired with 4 high-efficiency cores that offers comparable performance to an existing dual-core MacBook Air. It pairs with up to an 8-core GPU, which Apple claims to offer the world's fastest integrated graphics ever on processors. In addition, the M1 processor has a 16-core neural engine, a universal memory architecture, an Apple-designed Thunderbolt controller with support for a USB 4, an image signal processor, media encode and decode engines, and a host of security features. Sounds good, right? Okay, now let's talk about the graphics. The M1 includes up to an 8-core GPU and is the most advanced integrated graphic processors. It is claimed to provide twice performance of PC's chip's integrated graphics and can provide peak performance at a third of the power consumptions. It also includes a 16-core neural engine offering 11 trillion operations per second, with the entire chip designed to work optimal for machine learning. In terms of performance, Apple says it delivers up to 3.5 times faster CPU performance, up to 6 times faster GPU performance, and up to 15 times faster machine learning than previous generation of Macs. It also helps to enable battery life up to twice the length of the previous versions. Isn't this amazing? But that's not it, as there are quite significant changes in the battery life as well. Talking about the new MacBook Air, the chip allows us up to 18 hours of video playback on a single charge. Comparing it to the previous Mac, this is 6 hours more from the Intel Power MacBook Air. This can offer up to 15 hours of wireless web browsing per charge, which was 11 hours on the previous MacBook Air. And oh, have I mentioned the fact, due to the presence of a M1 in the MacBook Air 2020, the company has removed the fan, claiming that the processor itself is incapable of managing the operations so that MacBook does not heat up. This is amazing. I mean, now we will get to work on a Mac that's absolutely silent no matter what load it's handling. Talking about the MacBook Pro, the M1 makes the 17 hours of wireless web browsing and 20 hours of video playback possible. Apple claims that this new chip allows Macs to instantly wake up from the sleep mode, similar to the iPhones and iPad, and offers a good performance even when running 3D programs or editing 4K video files. The latest macOS Big Sur and its apps are also optimized for the new processor M1, which means a smooth user experience on a Mac like never before. Just the introduction of this chip has allowed the devices to have a 9 times faster machine learning speed and 2 times faster SSD speed. However, there are some possible drawbacks to keep in mind too. Because the RAM is now built inside the M1 chip, you won't have any option to upgrade the RAM according to your preference. I mean, if you take a look at the Apple's website, you will get an option to choose between 8GB and 16GB of unified RAM, but will have to pay $200 more. I really like the fact that M1 has a RAM that can be read by both CPU and GPU simultaneously, but that's way too much more money for 8GB of RAM. Anyways, those were my thoughts about this new development. What about you? What do you think about this new M1 chip? Let me know in the comments down below. I hope you found this video informative. If you did, then please give a big thumbs up to this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. I am Nikhil signing off. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay connected.